الرحمن الرحيم. Many people won't tell you the fact that the Hanafi scholars have greatly contributed towards Imam Bukhari's Sahih. Many people don't know this. Amongst the copious virtues and several virtues of Imam Bukhari's book Sahih, one of his excellence is that he has gathered 22 thulathiyat inside his book. 22 thulathiyat narrations. Now, thulathi narration is that narration that between Imam Bukhari rahimahullah and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there are three people, three narrators. This narration is called thulathi narration. Like this, there are 22 thulathiyat in Imam Bukhari rahimahullah's Sahih. Out of these 22 thulathiyat, 11 out of these 22 thulathiyat, 11 have been narrated from Imam Makki bin Ibrahim Balkhi. Imam Makki bin Ibrahim Balkhi rahimahullah, who passed away in 250 Hijri. All the great muhadithun, Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, Imam Nasa'i and Imam Ibn Ma'in, have agreed upon his authenticity. If you look at Imam Zahabi's Tazkirat al-Huffaz, volume 1, page 268. One of his teachers, Makki bin Ibrahim, who Imam Bukhari narrates 11 of his thulathiyat. And remember, my brothers and sisters, the thulathiyat of Bukhari is the cream and pride of Bukhari. Thulathiyat is the cream and pride of Bukhari. 11 of those ahadith, half of that cream and half of that pride, it is from Makki bin Ibrahim, who is a great muhaddith, like I've quoted. One of his great teachers in hadith, was Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. Imam Zahabi has mentioned six of his main teachers in hadith, of which one of them is Imam Abu Hanifa. You can find this in Tazkirat al-Huffaz, volume 1, page 268. Imam Muwaffaq bin Ahmad Makki, who passed away in 568 Hijri, has mentioned in his manaqib, in his excellence regarding Imam Abu Hanifa, that Makki bin Ibrahim, Imam Balkh, دخل كوفة سنة 40 و100 ولزم أبا حنيفة وسمع منه الحديث وأكثر عنه الرواية. That he, Makki bin Ibrahim al-Balkhi, Imam of Balkh, entered Kufa in the year 140 Hijri. He stayed in the company of Imam Abu Hanifa. And learned hadith and fiqh from him. And he excessively narrated hadith from Imam Abu Hanifa. This can be found in his manaqib on page 179. Imam Makki bin Ibrahim lived a very long life. Imam Makki bin Ibrahim, the teacher of Imam Bukhari and the student of Imam Abu Hanifa, he lived a very long life and was amongst the great teachers of Imam Bukhari. Hence, Imam Zahabi has mentioned in Al-Ibar, volume 1, page 290, that Makki bin Ibrahim lived over 90 years. And he was from the greatest teachers of Bukhari. وَهُوَ مِنْ كِبَارِ شُيُوخِ الْبُخَارِ. Rather, listen very carefully. Rather, it was because of Imam Abu Hanifa's encouragement. That Makki bin Ibrahim began to seek knowledge and learn hadith. That's why Imam Makki bin Ibrahim states himself, فَلَا أَزَالُ أَدْعُو لِأَبِي حَنِيفَةَ في دبر كل صلاة وعندما ذكرته لأن الله تعالى ببركته فتح لي باب العلم. I always make supplication for Imam Abu Hanifa after every salah and when I remember him. Why? Because Allah Almighty through Abu Hanifa's blessing opened the door of knowledge for me. This can be found in Manaqib of Imam Abu Hanifa by Imam Makki, page 179. Due to the fact that he was a student of Imam Abu Hanifa, he adhered to his school and was a very strong Hanafi. The greatest teacher of Imam Bukhari, Makki bin Ibrahim, was a Hanafi. He was a student of Imam Abu Hanifa. This can be found in the manaqib of Imam Abu Hanifa by Makki, page 179. وَكَانَ يُحِبُّ أَبَا حَنِيفَ حُبًّا شَدِيدًا وَيَتَعَصَّبُ لِمَذْهَبِهِ. He greatly loved Abu Hanifa and was fanatical towards his school. Some might criticize the above text saying that he was an extreme Hanafi or biased. However, the point here is that he was a clear Hanafi. That's the point. Forget if he was biased or not, but he was a clear Hanafi. So let me give you the net result. The net result, the khulasa kalam, the summary, number one, half of Imam Bukhari's thulathiyat, which is the cream and the pride of Bukhari, is from his great Hanafi teacher. Number two, amongst Imam Bukhari's greatest teachers of hadith, he became what he became because of Imam Abu Hanifa. Number three, Imam Bukhari's great teacher learned hadith from Imam Abu Hanifa. Number four, Imam Bukhari's great teacher was encouraged to learn hadith by Imam Abu Hanifa. Number five, Imam Bukhari's great teacher in hadith would pray for Imam Abu Hanifa after every salah and whenever he would mention him. Number six, Imam Bukhari's great teacher acknowledges that it was due to the barakah and blessing of Imam Abu Hanifa that Allah Almighty opened the door of knowledge, hadith and fiqh for him. The question is, if the teacher of Imam Bukhari, the teacher of Imam Bukhari, who is the pride of Bukhari, who is the creed of Bukhari, who is the cream and pride of Bukhari, is such a great muhaddith, and whose thulathiyat is the cream of Bukhari, one must wonder how his teacher was Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. The net reason khulasa is that Imam Bukhari's pride, Imam Bukhari's cream of his book, is the legacy of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. The 11 hadith, I would like to give you the reference where these hadith are, and you can find them, and you'll find the word Makki bin Ibrahim in the Sanad. Hadith 109, hadith 497, hadith 502, hadith 561, hadith 2007, hadith 2289, hadith 2960, hadith 3041, hadith 4206, hadith 5,497. How much is that? 10. Tilka ashara kamila. And number 11, hadith 6,891. No doubt, no shak, bila raib wa shak, Imam Bukhari's cream and pride is the legacy of Imam Azam, Numan bin Thabit, Abu Hanifa, radiyallahu ta'ala an. Wa akhir da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.